Just outside of Washington, D.C., bald eagles circle overhead as the Potomac River tumbles off of Appalachian bedrock into the Atlantic coastal plain. The resulting cascade was known and named by the first colonists the Great Falls of the Potomac. Here the river's considerable volume plunges 80 feet in a few hundred yards through dozens of channels, making it one of the most violent and spectacular natural displays in the United States. So, here's the idea. How about a race through the Great Falls in kayaks? Though long considered unrunnable, a number of routes through Great Falls have been paddled since an anonymous first descent in 1976. The Spout, the Fingers, and the Fish Ladder. Enter the World Kayak Federation and 25 of the world's best whitewater paddlers here for the World Kayak Federation Extreme Kayak Pre-World Championships.
Extreme kayaking is class 5 whitewater.
Extreme.
You need a lot of skill and a lot of strength.
Extreme!
Sideways in the hull, boom, 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 end over end.
You really need to be on or else you can get really screwed up. And it's steep.
The twisting route for this event is the Fish Ladder. 5 major drops down steep slides into hydraulics ranging from merely mean to terminal. The course is fast, tight, and constricted. High-speed hairpin turns, cheek-to-cheek with undercut rock walls and jagged midstream boulders.
Were there questions?
At the bottom, a thundering 30-mile-an-hour rush to thread the needle between a rock and, yes, you guessed it, a hard place. This is the outer limits of paddling, and the world's best are here to race, not only against the clock, but head-to-head, 3 boats at a time down the infamous Fish Ladder.
Way to fall.
Among the top finishers in Saturday's qualifying runs, Dan Gavere, renowned paddling and snowboarding bad boy from Salt Lake City, Utah. Eric Jackson, Olympic slalom racer and world champion rodeo paddler from Maryland. Arnd Schaeflein, world traveling extreme paddler and video star from Germany. And Jason Beakes, an aspiring young U.S. slalom team paddler and a Washington, D.C. local. The safety crews are out in force because at this level, not even the experts can make it look easy. On Sunday, the morning air is thick with apprehension as the kayakers check their 3-boat groupings and plan strategy for running the treacherous Fish Ladder once again, this time with company.
It'll make for more carnage. It'll make for a good race.
If you're the person in the front, you're stoked because then you're leading the way.
Head-to-head makes, you know, changes some variables.
If you're the person back, you're psyched because you know nobody's going to hit you when you drop into a hole.
It's full contact out there, you know. It just takes a little nudge and you can just get spun out or eddied out.
But if you're the person in the middle, they got people coming on top of you and you're going into people.
Knock the other guy on the wall if he tries to pass me.
You know, a couple bumps and bruises, but nothing significant. So.
Six heats of 3 boaters each determine the semifinalists. Eric Jackson leads until the last drop, but falls victim to the yawning hole at the bottom.
Coming in, big lead, look behind me, nobody behind me, take my time. A little too close to the rocks, minor adjustment. Whoa, poosh, gone. See ya.
Gil Rocha suffers a worse fate, breaking his boat on the rock wall a few feet from the finish.
I just played it safe, and I peeked on the right side. Got knocked back into the current, let them both pass me. Caught a little knob sticking out of that retaining wall on the right side and just hit it dead on, kind of bent it up a little bit.
And Kyle Marinello spends some quality time in the violent recirculating hole at the bottom of the course.
I came into the middle of the hole and just got thrown around a bunch, and I tried to roll up a few times, but it was just holding me underwater. And then it finally ripped my paddle out, and I tried a few hand rolls, and I just couldn't get my head to the surface.
Now in the semifinals, Jason Beakes is very fast and very clean and earns a shot at the top prize money. Dan Gavere prevails in his heat, and the final matchup is set. In the finals, Jason, paddling in the lead, turns too hard in the fourth drop and flips on a submerged rock. He rolls up just in time to avoid dropping off the next ledge upside down, but loses the lead to Gavere. The two battle for advantage in the final eddy, but it's Dan Gavere who pushes across first for the win. Riding high and $2,000 richer, Dan Gavere from Salt Lake City, Utah, is the World Kayak Federation's first professional extreme kayak champion.
I tried to catch the corner real tight, and I had a good line through there, and right as I was coming through there, he was rolling up.
I thought I'd take a more aggressive line, and I hit some rocks and flipped over. It cost me the race.
Back on the last drop, he's like, "Where's Sam?" And I was like, "No, I missed that line, missed that line. I'm right behind you, man."
Next time when I look back, it was after the finish line.
Totally psyched. I thought it was a fabulous race. I mean, it was so exciting. I love the head-to-head idea. It makes it possible for the spectators to like see who's winning and not have to wait around for all those times. The finish was outstanding, but the whole thing was great.
The World Kayak Federation is the international governing body for extreme kayak racing and sponsors a series of World Cup and World Championship extreme whitewater events. Racing in Class 5 and Class 6 whitewater involves significant risk of injury or death. Only the most highly skilled boaters are invited to participate, and they do so alongside the most experienced and best-equipped safety crews available. The World Kayak Federation is dedicated to pushing the boundaries of paddle sport by organizing exciting and safe extreme whitewater racing events.